The day has come to once again bask in the glory of the work done by the necromancers of engineering over in Shenzhen, who have been toiling away on another abomination of a graphics card. This time in the form of a 16 gig version of the RX 580. And here it is! This is one of them, I think. It should be in the box. The link on Aliexpress was sent to me by a viewer, so thank you very much for that. And in today's video, we're gonna see if we can actually use any of the extra video memory. Yeah, let's check it out. But before that, you ever wonder how RAM actually works? I always just assumed electricity goes in and then like magic makes computer things happen. Well, if you want the real answer to that question, you should probably check out today's video sponsor, Brilliant.org. Brilliant is the best way for you to learn intimidating topics like math and computer science interactively from the comfort of the least ergonomic position you can manage on your couch.
I'm learning.
I've recently been into Brilliant's new How Technology Works course, you know, with all that RAM learning. But you can try any of the thousands of lessons Brilliant has to offer free for 30 days. Just visit the link brilliant.org/David or click the link below, and the first 200 of you will get 20% off of Brilliant's annual premium subscription. That is some fancy packaging, which actually looks kind of familiar. I think this is the same company that made that weird mobile RTX 3060 die on like a normal graphics card PCB, the one that needed the virus drivers. Hopefully this one doesn't need the virus drivers, but we'll find out. We even get a box with some graphics on it. This kind of reminds me of the kind of packaging graphics you used to get like 10 or 15 years ago on graphics cards. It's kind of nostalgic. I am very excited to see this high frequency graphics card. And according to the back, apparently this is a 4K gaming graphics card, which makes sense considering the 16 gigs of video memory. Ooh, well, oh, that's not a great sign. Why did they use the 2048 SP version of the RX 580? That's like the loser die. Now, the standard version of the legendary RX 580 has 2,304 shader cores and 144 DMUs. But later down the line, AMD took a rusty scalpel to the RX 580, birthing the 2048 SP variant for the Chinese market. With, you guessed it, 2,048 shader units and 128 DMUs. Now, the reason I find it weird that they use this cutdown variant is because I can't really imagine that a normal RX 580, a mid-range graphics card from 600 years ago, reasonably being able to use more than 8 gigs of video memory, let alone the circumcised version. But I guess we'll find out later in the video. Now, getting back to the physical characteristics of the graphics card, it looks exactly how I expected it to look. It just looks like an Aliexpress graphics card. There's a decent looking cooler on here. It's nothing particularly fancy, but it should be able to handle that cut down RX 580 die without much problem. What is interesting is we just have a 6-pin supplemental power connector compared to the 8-pin that you often get on RX 580s. And then in terms of rear IO, it's pretty standard for cards from this era. We even get a DVI port, which is something you don't really see these days anymore. But with that, let's jump to the future after the testing to take off the cooler and have a closer look at all that video memory.
Oh my god. Ow.
There's our cooler. It is quite basic, but it's not nearly as basic as like a Wish GTS 450. You know, at least there's like heat pipes going on. We've got some actual thermal pad contact and stuff. And then here is our very reasonable 16 gig circumcised RX 580. Look at all those memory modules. They actually seem kind of sanded down. I know that these are Samsung modules, but you can't make out any of the information on them, which is interesting. And then back here is the power delivery. We've got 5 sturdy looking phases. And then the die looks disappointingly uncircumcised. It just looks like every other AMD die. So with that, let's drop it in a system and test it. Yes. Now, as a point of comparison, I'm starting out with an 8GB version of an RX 580. Now, unfortunately, this isn't a circumcised one. It's actually a pretty GigaChad version of the card. So it's not a fair comparison in that way. But by the end of the video, we'll see if we can find a use case where the circumcised 16GB card outperforms this all-natural 580. Starting off with Battlefield 5 at 1080p high settings, and the game is running very well on this Asus card. This is quite an easy to run map, but still, this is great performance for a card that's been around for as long as this has. Although there is something that's a bit worrying. Despite having 8 gigs of video memory available, at 1080p we're just seeing about 4 gigs of allocation, which is not looking promising for the scalpel victim. Now this is at 1080p medium settings, and it's a bit input laggy, but it is Cyberpunk. I feel like that's quite normal for the game. But even here, we're just seeing about 4 gigs of memory allocation, so I guess we're gonna have to start pushing up the resolution a bit. I'm sure the GPU will be fine with that. I mean, I think we just go straight to 4K. That's the way to do that. Okay, so we still don't have our entire memory pool allocated, but we're getting 14 frames per second with the more powerful GPU. Very good. Let's see if we can get the entire memory pool allocated. So let's jump the preset up to ultra with no fidelity FX. Oh, it's still hanging around 6 gigs, but now we're getting like 7 frames per second. Ew. Yes. There we go, 8 gigs high, and it's telling us it's gonna use about 10 gigs of video memory, which is good. That's what we want from it. Now we just need to hope that it can't run due to the memory bottleneck as opposed to the GPU. Oh, it's actually performing quite well. I'm guessing it's because everything other than high textures is on low, and despite our memory allocation being quite a bit higher than the other games, it's not anywhere near the 10 gigs we were promised, which I guess makes sense, considering that we don't have 10 gigs of video memory. Ah, yes, there we go. This is gonna be the game. So with medium settings at 1080p, we're hitting 7.5 gigs of memory allocation. So I'm assuming with some tinkering, The Last of Us is the game where we'll get the Abomination card to outperform this one. But first, let's see if that card needs some virus drivers. Oh, it's so much smaller. Hey, there we go. It immediately recognizes that it's the loser version of the card. Very good. Nice. The driver install just worked like any AMD card. That's very good. So now let's see how it performs. It's not running quite as well as the Asus card. And I think I can see why. Not only has the chip been brutalized, it's also clocked a lot less aggressively. So obviously it's not going to perform as well. And with Battlefield 5 at least, the loser's massive endowment is irrelevant. Interestingly, all of the scalpel work does mean that the cutdown card does use quite a bit less power. Now, when I moved over to Cyberpunk, the performance difference was even bigger because the core frequency on the 16GB card was just so conservative. So I decided to do a basic overclock on that graphics card just to even the playing field a little bit. So now that we've forced a halfway decent core frequency, which interestingly, the only way I could get it to work was through the auto overclock feature in AMD's drivers. Anything I did in MSI Afterburner, the graphics card would just ignore for some reason. But anyway, now the performance is a lot less tragic. And with all of that, you can see that the memory allocation is exactly the same as with the 8GB card. So not really benefiting from that, are we? But let's bump the resolution up to 4K to see if we can use some of this girth. We're still not seeing more than 6 gigs of video memory being allocated, although it's climbing, but it is still kind of getting curb stomped by the 8GB card. So let's try some other games. I don't think, again, it's running nearly as well as it was on on the Asus card, but look at that, we're getting close to being over our 8 gigs of memory allocation, which once that happens, the card will really start stretching its legs. Oh no, we've been downgraded massively. With the Asus RX 580, it defaulted us to medium with a rendered resolution of 720. Hey, the Video Memory Crusher 9000 at 1080p medium settings is not really video memory crushing, but it's kind of usable. We've got about 30 frames per second here, and it feels okay. But now we need to start cranking things.
I'm just gonna go just ultra. There we go. We've gotten over 8 gigs of video memory allocation. It's performing quite well. We haven't lost that much frame rate because we've got all this cozy memory headroom we can use. Hey. Next, I'm just gonna crank the render scale, giving us a rendered resolution of 4K. Yes, finally, we've gotten well over 10 gigs of video memory allocation, and we're cruising at 9 frames per second. This graphics card really is a 4K powerhouse. Actually, let's see how the 8GB card handles these settings. Hey, there we go. That's the result we were looking for. If only this Asus card had 16 gigs of video memory, we'd be getting 9 frames per second as opposed to whatever the hell's happening here. We did it, we got a result. That's exciting. Which brings us to the end of another video. Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed it, subscribe to the channel. If not, don't. I don't know, whatever. And until the next video, bye-bye.